Second Tesla Cybertruck Giga Press arrived in Texas. Tesla already has one 9,000-ton Giga Press installed at Giga Texas to produce the Cybertruck's body. But with over 1.5 million reservations for the electric truck, Tesla is going to need to build a lot of them, and it looks like it will soon get some help with the installation of a second IDRA Giga Press. According to important records uncovered by Cybertruck enthusiasts, more components from IDRA arrived in Texas this month. According to the bill of lading, a document issued by a courier to acknowledge receipt of cargo for shipment, the parts originated from Genoa, Italy, and were destined for Port Houston, where they arrived late last week, March 16, 2023, via Cybertruck Owners Club. The description of what's inside those boxes read, die casting machines parts. Additional shipping records show numerous crates from IDRA being shipped to Gigafactory Texas, again revealing they contain pieces of die casting machinery. I'm about to tell you why this is so important for Cybertruck production. Given these parts have only just arrived in Houston, and based on the timeline from where the first Giga Press arrived at Giga Texas, it will likely be several more weeks before they make their way to the Gigafactory to be installed. But based on how quickly the first Cybertruck Giga Press was installed, it won't be long after it arrives before it has up and running. That first Giga Press first appeared in Giga Texas in December, with several shipments arriving over the course of a few weeks. By mid-January, drone operator Joe Techmeyer was able to capture the massive machine being installed through a window in the casting area of the factory, along with glimpses of what appeared to the Cybertruck molds. Sadly, Tesla didn't like promptly covered them windows up by preventing any further views of the progress toward the start of Cybertruck production. The Giga Press is just one piece of the Cybertruck production puzzle. Tesla has also taken delivery of a small army of KUKA robots that will help put the Cybertruck together as it moves down the production line. The company has also been busy publishing job postings for dozens of positions related to Cybertruck production. All of these developments show that Tesla is getting seriously close to the production, or at least the test production, of Cybertruck. In fact, I noticed in the news this morning that in Fremont area, there are more frequent sightings of Tesla Cybertruck on the road, Cybertrucks on the road. And especially now the KUKA robots, those are those hand robots that you see in car manufacturing, and the die casting machine from coming from IDRA in Italy. These are all serious signs. Plus, the hiring of more workers for the Cybertruck production show me, and hopefully you too, that by the end of summer, we should see several thousand Cybertrucks, hopefully produced by Tesla Giga Texas. Would you agree with that? What are your thoughts on that, friends? Tesla has three new vehicles coming. Here they are, but they're coming along with electric planes and chips. If you read Tesla's Master Plan Part 3, you saw Tesla's planned vehicle lineup and that it included three new vehicle models. These are a compact car, in the opinion of Jeremy Johnson, Torque News Tesla reporter, and or at least two variations of that, a van and a bus. This is the first time that Tesla has made it clear that these are products they're going to work on. They are important products for many reasons. First, the compact car and its Model 3 and Model Y variations will enable Tesla to reach 20 million per year production rate of electric vehicles. These vehicles will cost between $20,000 to $28,000 or so and enable Tesla to reach the mass market. Second, these vehicles will accelerate the advancement of autonomous vehicles much faster. Because these vehicles are going to be made in half the time and cost half as much, they are going to flood the streets with vehicles gathering data, which will in turn accelerate Tesla's autonomous vehicle lead and enable the cars to finally drive themselves without human interventions. To be honest, I don't like that very much. Anyway, Third, the van will enable transportation of goods and people autonomously at large scale, which will reduce emissions in the air and clean our city airs. All of these vehicles will reduce emissions in the air. The van will also allow people to have an autonomous and green energy vehicle that they can live in off-grid. I think there are many people who would buy a Tesla van with only a passenger and driver sitting in it. Fourth, the bus will further enable transport of large amounts of people autonomously. I can see Tesla making a bus network that puts city buses out of business due to the low cost and operating autonomously, says Torque News Tesla reporter Jeremy Johnson. And fifth, he says, Tesla will write software that makes these buses operate autonomously and function just like a city bus, except paying for them will be very inexpensive and they will continuously drive themselves until they need to charge. Tesla may even find a way to charge them and have overlapping buses drive while others recharge. I see a large network of buses replacing city buses. This means they have to produce a lot of them. These three vehicles are very disruptive vehicles. And if you look at Tesla's roadmap with Master Plan Part 3, the company is about 10 years away from even maturing as a large company. It's a very exciting time for Tesla. Tesla has plans to build other things also. What about planes and boats? Have you ever thought about that? If you look at page 23 of Tesla's slide deck for Master Plan Part 3, you can see the following. Tesla sees about 2.1 PWH of annual demand if ships charge about 70 times per year on average, and then charge of 75% of capacity each time. With this, you need about 40 terawatt hour of batteries to electrify the ocean fleet. The assumption is that 33% of the fleet will require a higher density nickel and manganese based cathode, and the other 2.3 will use LFP batteries. For planes, if 20% of the around 15,000 narrow body planes fleet is electrified with a 7 megawatt hour total impacts, then 0.02 terawatt hour of batteries will be required there. Here is a summary. First, longer range ship nickel manganese battery, 12 terawatt hour total fleet. Shorter range ship LFP battery, 28 terawatt hour total fleet. Planes, high nickel battery, 0.02 terawatt hour of total fleet. A total of 40 terawatt hour is needed to achieve this. Advancements in batteries will help accelerate this development. For example, Amprius developed a battery that is around 500 Wh kilogram, and if this battery proves to work and have a long life, it will absorb existing batteries for flight, where energy density is of utmost importance. So what do you think, friends, of Tesla's three new vehicles and planes and boats? Will Tesla build a bus network that puts city buses out of business? Indonesia will offer a limited free trade deal with the US on critical minerals. If the agreement is signed, then Tesla and other companies could greatly benefit from it. Indonesia will offer a free trade agreement for some mineral supplies to the US, according to Reuters report. This will create conditions for companies operating in the electric vehicle battery supply chain to take advantage of US tax incentives, a senior minister said on Monday. The US government released new guidance on tax credits for electric vehicles under the Inflation Reduction Act, IRA. It requires certain battery components to be manufactured or assembled in North America or from a free trade partner. The rules aim to ride on US dependence on China to develop the electric vehicle battery supply chain. At the moment, Indonesia does not have a free trade agreement with the US. However, the fact is that its nickel products are becoming increasingly important in the supply chain. With the growing popularity of electric vehicles, the demand for nickel is also growing. Companies such as Tesla and Ford could benefit from the signing of the agreement. Also, like many other manufacturers in the United States, those working in this area will benefit from the agreement. Asked about the new IRA guidelines, Indonesian Minister Luhut Panjaitan, who is leading efforts to attract US companies such as Tesla, said at a press conference that Jakarta will offer Washington a limited free trade agreement. He said, "We do not have an FTA with them. Now we're proposing a limited FTA with them," Luhut said, adding that he would meet with Ford and Tesla executives to discuss the matter when he travels in the United States later this week. Luhut's deputy Sepahyan Haryo said the FTA proposal is likely to be similar to what the U.S. has signed with Japan regarding trade in key materials. The country has agreed on trade deal with EV battery minerals, including lithium, nickel, cobalt, graphite, and manganese. It's the same, in essence, that for critical minerals, there will be free trade with requirements on processing, such as for nickel, aluminum, cobalt, copper, he said. Not the important part in this report, that he will meet with Tesla and other car manufacturer executives later this week to discuss all of this and the potential benefits and probably the involvement of Tesla and other major electric vehicle manufacturers in the United States. This is a very important development, in my opinion. This is why I said in that Tesla may greatly benefit, and not only benefit from this, and not only Tesla, but also other car companies or other companies that are involved in the supply chain. And this may potentially also lower the prices of the supply materials necessary for electric vehicle manufacturing. Therefore, this can benefit the car buyers in down the road, lowering the prices or allowing Tesla and other car companies to further lower electric car prices. Thanks for watching, everyone. This is Armen Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you found these reports interesting, please give us thumbs up and like this video and subscribe to our channel. Also, ring the bell after you subscribe so you don't miss my next coverage. And also, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. God bless you and your families. Have a great day. I'll see you soon in our next report.